Yes, guys, welcome back to another video. Welcome to the George Benson Football Channel for six things that we learned from Chelsea 3, Southampton 1. The video is late for unforeseen circumstances that actually made me miss the ending of the game, but all is good, all is well, and at least during an international break, you thought you'd heard enough about Chelsea beating Southampton, but there is no football for two more weeks, which is a little bit sad for all of us involved because the mighty Chelsea have finished the Premier League weekend top of the table. We have gone to Arsenal, we have gone to Liverpool, we've gone to Spurs, and after seven matches, we've lost only one game, and we are top of the Premier League. It is an absolutely beautiful sight. If you guys enjoyed the win and you're happy that we're top of the league, hit the like button on today's video. And if you've got any videos that you would like to see me make that are less about what's currently going on at Chelsea, and maybe it's a tier list video, maybe you want to see some top 10s, top 5s, let me know in the comments below, because we've got 2 weeks with no games. We've got World Cup qualifiers, but you guys know, and we've all pretty much made this a Chelsea YouTube channel. So let me know your recommendations below. As for the game itself, it was actually a very entertaining football, as the majority of matches this weekend, apart from bloody Burnley and Norwich, shocked that one, most of the games this weekend were very entertaining. Southampton did not play badly at all. I think Chelsea deserved more goals than we actually scored. I think that the Timo Werner disallowed goal is criminal. I cannot believe that A, they've pulled it back that far, B, they've pulled it back for a foul, when I never even think it's a foul in the first place. But that is by the by. Chelsea got 3 points. We've got another 3 goals. We're scoring goals, and the goals are coming from all over the field. But without any further ado, box number one, I am absolutely delighted for this man, and I'm delighted to give box number one a blue box for Timo Werner. There were some fantastic performances all across the field from Chelsea. There were goals that were made in Cobham. There was probably one of our goal of the season contenders, which was Timo Werner's goal. He did score another header too, which again, I think he deserved 2 goals in this game. It wasn't given, but the goal that he did score. Let's talk about the move for a start. Ross Barkley, going to save a line or two for him because we're going to talk about him later. What a ping that is with the inside of his boot, kind of like a mixture between the instep and the tip of your boot. Absolutely pings one diagonally to Azpilicueta, who, by the way, as much as Ross Barkley 100% deserves an unlimited amount of praise for the phenomenal vision of that pass, Azpilicueta's control for the first time ball is simply sublime. And the way that he makes that run with enough time to get his foot over it to drill it across the box, Timo Werner was there, right place, right time. And I think I said earlier this season that with Lukaku and Werner playing together, it's going to benefit both of their games. And I think in this game, as much as I don't think Lukaku might have had his best game again, it did definitely bring the best out of Timo Werner. The runs that he made were made with a lot more freedom because the Southampton defenders were so focused on dealing with Lukaku that they didn't give Timo Werner the respect that, as he proved in this game, he duly deserves. I think there's never really a question about Timo Werner's work rate. He always puts in a massive, massive shift for the team. But the fact he got that goal, it's his first goal of the season again after another one being ruled out. It's like this guy has the worst luck when it comes to VAR. I think that's the 16th goal that Timo Werner has scored for Chelsea that has then been ruled out by the video assistant referee. And I don't think, for me, there was any question about this one. I think it should have been a goal. I don't like how they pull it so far back, and I also don't think it's a foul. So there's my rational justification, but Timo Werner, absolutely delighted for the man, and he gets himself his first blue box of the season. God, blimey. Into box number two, and there are more praise to be sang for Trevor Chalobah. Scores Chelsea's first goal. Brilliant instinctive flick from Ruben Loftus-Cheek. We'll get onto him in a moment. This is a positive one. I like this. Chalobah's arriving at the far post. And the header again, it's not the simplest of headers because it's a diving header and you've always got to really commit to those. You don't know what limbs are going to be flying in from any defenders trying to guard Southampton's goal. But again, it's just that poise to be in the right place at the right time. And some people may say, yeah, he's like 3 or 4 yards out and it's a pretty much an open goal from the position he's standing. You've got to commit to these things. And a player that hasn't played that much Premier League football in Trevor Chalobah, to have the confidence and the know-how to be positionally aware of where this ball could possibly land is incredibly smart. Now, it doesn't matter whether the goal's gaping or if there's defenders on the line. If you score a diving header in the box, you've done something right. You've committed to it. Trevor Chalobah did that. And I think it's not just the goal that really impresses me with Chalobah. His passing accuracy is absolutely fantastic. The way that he tries to carry the ball, or does successfully carry the ball out of Chelsea's defensive area, is fantastic. He contributes to the attack as much as he possibly can, as well as being incredibly astute both on the ground and in the air defensively as well. I think Chelsea have earthed an absolute gem in Trevor Chalobah, and I was delighted that he managed to get the goal. I've made it absolutely no secret here on GBFC that Ruben Loftus-Cheek, despite not playing very much for a couple of years in a Chelsea shirt, is still one of my favourite current Chelsea players. He's been one of my favourites ever since he broke into the first team and we started to hear the name of Ruben Loftus-Cheek. I was delighted that Thomas Tuchel gave him a start. I love the way that Thomas Tuchel sees something that doesn't work and was just so happy and did it without even thinking about it. Made five changes to the side that started the game against Juventus. Ruben was one of those who came in, and the flicked-on header to Chalobah, yes, I mean, maybe he could have been going for goal. We could play devil's advocate for just one brief moment, but I believe that Ruben knew exactly where his teammate who came up through the academy in Cobham, Trevor Chalobah, was. And it wasn't just the assist, which of course is what most of us were talking about. Ruben's back contributing goals to Chelsea Football Club. His all-round play, the fact that he tries to drive forward with the ball at his feet, whether it's in a tight area with two players around him, or when he's in and around the 18-yard box, he's always trying to progress, whether he's got the ball or whether he doesn't have the ball. Ruben is very good at getting into progressive areas to get himself into opportunities to fully contribute to the final stages of a Chelsea attack. And I think he did himself absolutely no troubles whatsoever with the performance he put in the other day. Chelsea might even be looking at that signing of Saul Niguez, thinking Saul Niguez cannot get in this team. If N'Golo Kante's fit, we know who's playing. Kante, Kovacic, Jorginho, and now Ruben Loftus-Cheek. Ruben has firmly cemented himself as a huge potential player for Chelsea this season. It was another good performance from him, and we move into a man who I am very happy for indeed. He scored the third goal, and it's actually in the context of, like, the ball didn't hit the back of the net, you didn't see the net break, but it's a fabulous strike from Benjamin Bloody Chilwell. Gets his first goal of the season back in the starting 11. I think it's absolutely no surprise to me that Ben Chilwell took the opportunity that he had. I wouldn't say before the goal that it was his perfect display. There was definitely a bit of rust in those legs, I think, from not playing much football now for quite some time. But I was absolutely delighted. Chilwell's finish, again, arriving in the box just at the right moment, just at the right time. And I was delighted for the man. I've given him a green box today because he's back in the side and to contribute to a Chelsea victory, scoring the decisive goal. Yes, when we went 2-1 up playing against 10 men, we should be okay. But that goal absolutely sealed the deal for the boys in blue. We move into another inspired Thomas Tuchel substitution, Mason Mount. I thought Mount was excellent when he came on. I think what we see when Mason Mount is in the team is, once again, bringing it back to what I said about Werner and Lukaku. Southampton players will obviously focus a lot of their time and energy on Romelu Lukaku. When Timo Werner is there as well, it's great because he can also get into those attacking positions, playing as part of what looked to be at times like a pretty solid front two. Mason Mount again adds another dynamic element to the Chelsea attack. We know how good he is at transitioning Chelsea's play when we're stuck in tight areas, just either in our own 18-yard box or just outside the box, and you've got one of the defenders or a Kovacic to win the ball back. Mason Mount is the man that connects what we do in a defensive position to transition it into the forward areas. And once again, when Mount comes on, the Southampton players have another attacking threat to really be worried about. I wouldn't necessarily say they would have been too worried about Ruben because he was kind of a bit deeper. Jorginho, Kovacic, these kind of players too. You don't really feel threatened by them in the final third unless it's Kovacic doing what he keeps doing, which is putting in some brilliant balls. And Kovacic was very good also in this game, by the way. Didn't give him a box because I wanted to address the points of the others. I thought Mason Mount was excellent, brilliant energy when he came on. And you could argue, and I know some would argue against it because they like to, Mason Mount changed the bloody game. But we move into box number 6, and I'm so happy for this man because even though I thought, I'm not going to lie to you, I didn't think Ross Barkley would get a sniff again in this Chelsea team. Again, he comes on ahead of Saul Niguez. Just point in case here, I think Saul Niguez's loan move to Chelsea is going to be a personal struggle for the player. I don't think he's going to get many minutes. Ross Barkley came on, and you see flashes of those moments of link-up with Lukaku. We saw it in Turin on Wednesday night when they linked up together and Lukaku absolutely fluffed his lines. Ross Barkley's ball to Azpilicueta. I said about it earlier, but it's sensational. We've known that Ross Barkley is a technically gifted footballer. It's just that Chelsea, I feel as though he's never really grown in to any position he's been given. And it's kind of hard for him because Chelsea reached dizzying heights for pretty much all of the footballers in the world who don't play for Chelsea because we're the best team in Europe. But Ross Barkley came on the pitch and he was brilliant. He was trying to link up with Lukaku again. You can see that combination working well. The ping to Azpi is absolutely delightful. For me, it's my favourite goal that Chelsea have scored this season. And I'm just very happy to see Ross Barkley being A, given an opportunity from Thomas Tuchel, using that squad that he has, and B, Ross Barkley, in the small amount of minutes that he's been given, has absolutely contributed to the team, which is all you can ask for a player in the Chelsea squad. 3-1 to Chelsea, six things we learned. Let me know the six things that you guys learned in the comments down below. It's going to be a little bit quiet over the course of the next couple of weeks, but as I said earlier, if you have any recommendations for any video ideas, one-off videos that we can do, let me know in the comments. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you for your patience again. As I said at the beginning, I won't go into much details about it, but had a bit of a stressful one on Saturday and I had to deal with a few things. But anyway, thank you guys for watching. I'll see you all later. Come on, you Blues.